Hey, Collider fans. Well, we got ourselves a new trailer this morning from Rian Johnson. He wrote and directed this movie, Knives Out. John Rocha here with Dennis Zenn. Dennis, you're excited for this film, coming on the heels of The Last Jedi, all the crap he took. Now he's moving on to something a little more in his wheelhouse than we've seen before, a murder mystery thriller type movie. You've seen the cast here. Does this excite you to see the trailer?
Yeah, it does excite me. I mean, I'm a big fan of murder mysteries. Mm-hmm. Unlike you, I'm a big fan of Clue. So I'm you know, I see this cast here. Yeah. I see it's a murder mystery. I want to see if it's going to have this, some humor to it. Mm-hmm. What kind of, how much, like, he's done thrillers type stuff before. I mean, yeah. Even with something like Brick, which was a crime mystery, you had Brothers Bloom that had a little more, you know, fun to it.
Yeah.
I'm just wondering how this is going to go. It's also interesting just because Rian Johnson is obviously coming off of The Last Jedi, which I enjoyed, but obviously he got a lot of crap from fans for.
He did. But he stayed connected to the fandom, stayed connected to Star Wars, and that's a positive because he's got that trilogy that's supposed to come out. But this is something that almost feels like Murder on the Orient Express with the size of the cast, right? Mm-hmm. Ana de Armas, Chris Evans, Daniel Craig, Michael Shannon, Jamie Lee Curtis, Toni Collette, Catherine Langford, Lakeith Stanfield, Ricky Lindholm, and, oh, Don Johnson, who I interviewed on The Deep Cut, and he talked about how much he enjoyed working with Rian Johnson on this film. So I'm excited. He got me excited, so I'm excited to see this trailer. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, let's do it.
I suspect foul play and eliminated no suspects.
Ooh. Yeah, definitely a Clue vibe already. Mm-hmm.
I'm Detective Lieutenant Elliot, and this is Trooper Wagner. We just want to ask a few questions. Mm. Well, we understand the night of his demise, the family have gathered to celebrate your father's 85th birthday.
Christopher Plummer, nice.
How was it?
The party? Pre my dad's death? Oh, it was great.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to request that you all stay until the investigation is completed.
What?
Can we ask why? Has something changed?
No.
No, it hasn't changed, or no, we can't ask.
I'm gonna live until I die.
You think one of his family
walls killed? Is that what you're suggesting?
You all love twisting the knife into one another.
Up your ass.
Oh, very nice.
Eat shit.
Wow, Captain America.
Eat shit. Eat shit.
Yikes.
Eat
shit.
Smug smile.
Definitely eat shit.
Whoa.
Something. Spill it.
I suspect foul play. And I have eliminated no suspects.
I'm gonna live.
It's a twisted web. We are not finished untangling it, not yet.
Oof. What is this? CSI KFC?
Interesting. Wow. All right, Dennis Zeng, first reactions.
I enjoyed it a lot. Yeah. I liked it. It definitely has a Clue vibe to it. Obviously, it's more modern than that. That you see some humor in there, the mystery. I'd say the only thing, because I had read a little bit about it before, was why three detectives? It's always one or two, right? It's either the solo brilliant mind or you got this partner situation. Mm-hmm. Three just seems a little much because you already got this ensemble cast. You don't want to have the detectives have like so many in there. That's my only reservation, but otherwise it looks great.
Yeah, I would agree with you on that. And I thought the Daniel Craig thing was about the only thing that felt a little weird in the trailer. Everything else looks a lot of fun, certainly more fun than Clue was for me. And I'm excited to see what this ends up being. Because, you know, right in the opening, they mentioned The Last Jedi in terms of the graphics on the screen and also mentioned Looper, one of these great films that I thoroughly enjoyed from him. So this could be one of those like twists and turns type films. You don't know what happens at the end. And everyone loves a good mystery. So I think, as I said, on the heels of Murder on the Orient Express, it's nice to see that the public, they sense, the studios maybe sense the public's taste for these kinds of films is starting bubbling back up again. So I hope this one turns out to be a really good one and a fantastic cast. What a great mix of veterans and newer actors and actors that have been here for just a little bit. I like this combo, and you don't know what's going to happen, so that's great. And Ana de Armas barely had any screen time, so they're probably holding her character back a little bit because Don Johnson mentioned that she's a really big part of the movie. So I'm excited to see that.
Yeah, you mentioned like these kind of mysteries kind of coming back into kind of prominence. You had something that was not that big of a mystery, but like Netflix dropped that murder mystery movie with Jennifer Aniston and Adam Sandler, and definitely not close to this,
right.
But it did very well for them. So, you know, these comedy mysteries or mystery comedies, maybe that's something that's going to be explored more.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm looking forward to it. All right, well, let us know what you think. You saw the trailer. Yeah, it's got some cuss words with the red band trailer there. Let us know what you thought in the comment section. Blah, blah. Are you excited to see this now from Ryan Johnson? Do you like this cast, or did the trailer not do it for you? Let us know there. Remember to like and share this video on your social media and subscribe to Collider. For more trailer reactions just like that, that's Dennis Zen. I'm John Rocha. We'll see you soon.